Good morning, folks. Ooh, it's a little on the chilly side today. And I just realized I forgot my sweater, but it's already 7:24. So I have a light jacket at work I can wear. Sort of light. All right. It is beautiful Wednesday today. Yeah, my arms are cold. Oh, that kind of sucks because it's gonna rain later and I got my Proctogs with me, but my arms, this jacket doesn't hold up, which it's supposed to. I sprayed it with Scotch Guard, so it should be waterproof, but and actually I think it is an all-weather jacket, although it's freaking hot in the summer, I'll tell you that. So I have to get one of those jackets that has mesh in the front for the summer. That would be better. Well, it's too late now. It's okay. That's all right. Thank you. Anyway, Lexus. Thank you, man. Thank you. Yeah, so, let me over, dude. Don't try to be the hero and not let a motorcyclist through. Don't try to be the hero. Yeah, so I got my cart. It's taking too long. I can't wait for you. I got my cart and it's nice. And I put music on it. The person who had to put it in my room was none other than the plant manager. And I happened to be in the hallway when he was pushing it towards my room. He gave me this smirk like, like the cat with the mouse kind of smirk like, yeah, I know why I'm pushing this right now. And I said, yeah, you can put that in my room. Thank you so much for bringing that over here from the office. Thank you. He's like, no problem. And I'm sure they've already seen that I've marked it music. And it's still sitting in the same spot in my room. So that's a win. That's right, it's a win. So I had those boys put it together and they did a good job. At first I had two kids from my second period and I'm like, they could probably do it. They got that shit all backwards. I was like, get out of here. Not even doing it right. Move. I'm kidding, I wouldn't say that to them. They're good kids, and they said, if Miss gets this right, because I don't think we got it right, but if she gets it right, we're not scholars. I said, you know what, you guys for the most part got it right. I said, there's just this little spot over here. I said, but don't worry about it. Thank you for your help, and you guys got to go to your next period now, so, but you guys did good. Yeah, but we messed up that part. No, don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. You guys did me a solid. Don't worry. Then I got those boys. And they tried to take up the whole period doing that. I was like, this is going to take about 10 minutes of your time. Oh, well, we got to do this and we got to do that. Yeah, I don't think so. I mean, if it's gonna take you guys that long, then I'll just have somebody else do it. Oh no, we'll do it. We'll do it. Gosh, anything not to play a guitar, which is so weird. It's like, who wouldn't want to play guitar? I don't get it. But anyway, I just realized I forgot to put on my airbag. So in other news, us teachers had a meeting. Apparently, people are getting written up for weird shit, being pulled into the principal's office, not knowing what their rights are with the union, possibly needing a union rep. So, you know, it's kind of went over some ed code and kind of keep us all working in our positions. Which is really strange. I've never heard of teachers getting pulled in. Really, I haven't. And I've worked many years. And it's just I don't know. I've never heard of that happening. People getting reprimanded left and right for whatever. Everything has changed with this principal. She's by the book. And you have to be flexible in this job. You just have to be. You have to be flexible. But I don't see flexibility coming from this person. Like, where's the flexibility with the assistant principal that barks at everybody and is rude to everyone? And this principal who wants to go through, you know, make us go through fire hoops and walk over coals to get shit. I don't get it. You want us to be flexible, but you don't want to be flexible. And, you know, fuck the holiday cheer, because we're not having our Thanksgiving banquet that we have every year before we leave. We usually have a potluck, and our old principal used to bring in catered food from around the area, supporting the community, right? Not this year. And I asked to have more time for my concert that I put on every year for all the sixth graders. That's, you know, the teachers, I'll tell them, hey, you know, we're going to have a concert for the sixth graders on this date. And it's usually the day that we have our evening concert. And this year I was told, oh, well, we can't do that. We don't have time for all that. Something else is going on during that time, and we can't do that. And wow, look at this shit. It's all backed up. Damn. This is weird for a Wednesday. But anyway, I was like, so there's nothing that can be done now? So we'll just have our evening concert then. Okay. Which really sucks, because it's so much fun to have a concert during the day. It's like a big assembly, and everybody comes, and they hear what we've been doing the first half of the year, and the kids are excited to play for their friends, and it's just, no, can't do it. So my assistant's like, well, you could technically do it. First of all, he's not going to be there to handle any of this, so it's like, technically you can do it by getting the kids early, like an early lunch, and having them show up early, and having the rehearsal at this time, that, all this shit. And I'm like, you know what, no, I'm not doing that shit, no. And I hate to do that to the kids, because the kids, you know, it's for them. But the second I do that, you guys, I'm telling you right now, the second I do that, it's going to be like that. You fucking idiot. You're a fucking stupid ass. Fucking asshole. Fucking dumbass. Don't do it, stupid. The second I do that shit, that's going to be every year from here on out. Oh, well, she did it last year. Yeah, but I have more students. Well, you did it last year. But I have more students. It doesn't matter. You did it last year. Yeah, a lot of students last year, I remember. Yeah, you did it last year. We don't have to flip this advisory time for you. We don't have to do that for you, no. You did it last year. I'm not doing that shit. I am not going there. I'm telling you guys, I'm not. I won't budge. Because, hey, you know what? Guess what? We gotta do things by the book. And that's by the book, as far as I'm concerned. That's by the book. You gotta flip the advisory, and if you don't, oh well, you don't get a concert. The kids don't get to have their concert during the day. Too bad, too sad. Move the fuck out of the way, you dumb fuck. Damn. Oh, I'm just gonna take my fucking sweet ass time. I'm gonna take my sweet ass time going across here, because I'm dumb, as usual. So, yeah, I'm not doing it. You know, I love these kids, but I gotta stand up. And I gotta say, you know, I get pushed there. You guys don't even know. I haven't even said anything, but you guys don't even know. They're trying to take my assistant away now. They're trying to fucking take my assistant away now. They had a private fucking meeting with him. This bitch ass fucking assistant principal did. This assistant principal had, who barks at everybody, by the way, and is rude to everyone. She had a meeting with him, pulled him out during my class time and had a meeting with him when he's supposed to be working for me. He's only there a few hours in the morning. That's it. And she pulls him out. Well, we're going to have, other people need help. Other teachers need help. Really? Do other teachers have 38 students? Do other teachers have 40 students? Huh. I wonder. Oh, right. Oh, we went on strike to make sure the teachers have 25 students in the class. That's what we went to strike for. That's why I spent 3 weeks out in the fucking rain marching around for these teachers to have 25 students in their class. Me, I could have up to 40 some students in my class, which, to be honest, you guys, I don't mind because I have an assistant. And also too, it's great for instrumentation, right? We have like an awesome band, an awesome guitar orchestra, and it's awesome, right? But not at the expense of my sanity. I mean, I need a fucking assistant. That's why we hire music assistants. That's why there's a job in LAUSD for music assistants. There's a reason. And no, it's not just for high school directors. It's for middle school directors also. And it's bullshit that they're like, he's under a different category. Well, you know what? That's because the principal before was flexible and understood that this person does a lot of shit and they have to make more money. So he worked it out. And he said, you know, we could do it this way because I know he needs to come back and I understand he needs more money because he had left for school for a while. So it's like, shit just pisses me off. I'm like, really? Oh, but these teachers need help. That's such bullshit. Yeah, I'm the music teacher who doesn't need anything. I just need to go babysit. I need to babysit. That's why they dumped on me. I'm the babysitter. Fuck that shit. So, because he's not technically under the umbrella of an assistant, they're like, oh, well. And not only that, but this idiot, fucking dumbass. Not only that, but they took money from him. They cut his pay. So he's pissed. He's not my same assistant that I had that would get the band ready for me, or, you know, if I asked him to do this or that, he'd go, okay, no problem. Now it's like, no, I don't want to do that. I don't want to get the band ready for you. I told him, I said, you know, you're not, I know you're pissed, but we're paying for it. The kids are paying for it. I'm paying for it. I'm squished in the middle. They're squished in the middle. These people, between you and these admins, I'm screwed. Students are getting screwed too. He's like, I'm fucking burning the house with me inside of it. And I said, all of us are inside of it. All of us are in it together. And I don't want that. I want to have a good band, and I want to have, you know, but I need fucking help. And he's not there enough. I mean, he does what I ask him, like, as far as, like, paperwork and shit like that. Doesn't have to get the band ready for me or tune for me or whatever. I mean, the kids know how to tune, but he doesn't have to do that. That's my job. But it used to be really fucking helpful, you know, and he didn't mind doing it because he was getting paid. And then also too, he's going to school for this shit. He's not going to school for a teaching position, but he's going to school for music, and he's been doing this job forever. So that sucks, you know. And it sucks that his pay got taken out like that, too. I mean, we were having a really good run, and this bitch fucking fucked it all up. Fucked the shit up. And now it's like, you know, we're just, everybody's just so like, there's no like, the morale is low, you guys. It's low. The morale is low. And it sucks because usually around this time, everybody's so happy and cheerful and, you know, people are getting pulled into the fucking office, reprimanded for shit. It's so stupid. It's like, what, you know, come on, man. Get the fuck over, bus. Can you fucking move? Yes, I'm bitching and complaining because I'm mad at myself for not going for that job in Long Beach. I'm fucking pissed at myself for that. I should have jumped on that shit. I should have jumped on that shit. And you know, the people, there's people that left before, as they saw things starting to unfold, they left. They're like, I'm out. I'm resigning from this place. I can't take it anymore. Because I already see where this is going. And I hope those people are doing well because they're really good teachers. But they left. They saw this shit coming. I saw the storm coming too. But I was like, I got to stick it out. I got to stick out this storm. But maybe I should leave and not stick it out. And I decided to stick it out like a dumbass. And here I am, pissed. Pissed, pissed, and more pissed. Move the fuck over. Thank you. Stupid van back there. Anyway, so yeah, it's not a happy time. It's not a cheerful place anymore. It's just like, oh, watch your back. Gotta watch your back. Cover your ass. Cover your ass. Watch your back. You know, and I hate this attitude of, you know, somebody did something wrong, gotta report it. I say something. Instead of just, you know, the normal shit that would happen, like, you do something stupid, like I did, with the keys, with my classroom keys, you just go to the person and say, hey, you know, oh, man, you gotta watch it. Don't give anybody your keys, even if it's to open up this for that or whatever you need. Or you don't have somebody to do it, but you got a kid here that can do it. Don't do it. Don't let them... You know, instead, it's like, got reported to the assistant principal, and then this bitch went to the fucking principal and sent me an email, and all of a sudden, fucking paper trail going on. You fucking idiot, man. Yeah, all right. At least you put on your blinker. So, you know, it's like, oh, I'm gonna tell on her. I'm gonna tell on her because then somebody might have seen me see it, and they'll tell on me. It's so, like, fucking high school shit going on. And I love these teachers. They're all really, really nice people. The counselors, too, even though they dumped on my ass. It wasn't their fault. They just get told what to do. Here, do this. Do that. They can only do so much. But, I mean, they're nice people. But that... assistant principal who's now like, because one of our assistant principals left who was super nice, been with us forever, he left, and now this bitch is even more in charge. She's like the boss, or she thinks she's the fucking boss. She wants to be the boss, and that's just not coming just from me. It's coming from all the teachers. Yeah, it's just fucking rude, man. Doesn't include me on shit. So, I'm not the only one that she didn't include on that fucking meeting. Like, she's done this to other people, too, obviously. Because that's what I've been told. People don't like that. Teachers do not like that. We want to be included in the loop. This is my assistant that I've worked with for... Like, I've been with LAUSD, what, 6 years? Before that, I had worked at... two other districts, elementary districts, that one of them I didn't like. One of them, I was there, I liked it, everything was good, but I wanted to teach middle school, so that's why I left. And they warned me, they were like, oh, you don't want to go there, don't go because they're going to go on strike, and they did, and I dealt with it. I knew what I was facing, and I still wanted to do it because I've been wanting to teach middle school forever. So, here I am, 6 years into it, Well, I did teach it in school teaching and student teaching. I taught high school and middle school, but it's not the same thing, you know. But here I am, and I'm fucking pissed. I'm like, I'm just not happy. I'm happy with the kids. It's the fucking adults. It's the fucking admins. Not the adults, the admins. Because teachers are fine. But anyway, they just run things so differently, this principal and this assistant principal. They're like, don't want to keep you in the loop. And when you've worked with certain people for a certain amount of years, there's, oh, no. No, he needs to be over here. What are you doing over there? Does a lot of shit for me. Does a lot of shit for me. When he's there all day, he's fucking stringing guitars. He's making calls, translating for me. He's doing all kinds of shit. Copying. You know, there's always some shit to do. Helping me grade papers. I mean, there's always shit to do. And when you have these big classes, you get stacks of paper fast. That's why I try to do things more online, but, you know, these kids, they're like, oh. They, do things online, and then they kind of screw around. So I'd like to give them paper more than anything, but I get stacks of paper, and I have to go through them. I have to grade these things, and give them their grade, and he helps me with all that shit. None of these teachers have 40 kids. And I'm not mad at the teachers. It's the assistant principal is like, oh, well, they need help upstairs. No, they don't. Not like me. No. No, they don't. And there's a lot of assistants up there. So I don't even get that either. That's like a mute point or whatever she's trying to make. It's not... They have plenty of people up there. Fuck, man. This shit's crazy. What the hell is going on here? Ugh, fucking damn it, man. Well, I don't like doing this. It's just a tight squeeze. Don't try to be the hero and get in my way. I'm just trying to get out of people's way, okay? Don't get all bitchy about it. Get out of my way. Yeah, well, what are you doing, dickhead? Being a dickhead, huh? Oh, man. Come on, move. What are you doing, Tesla? Don't go, stupid. Of course. Thanks a lot, asshole. Well, I'll get through here anyway. You see, I'm skinny enough. There. How do you like that? Yeah, it's just... I need this fucking break, you guys. I need this break. I just turned on my airbag that I forgot all about. I need my week off to get... Just... I don't know what I need. I don't know. I mean... The principal already knows I want to leave because I want to be closer to home. Oh, shit. This whole thing's open. Oh, man. Hopefully, I didn't lose everything in it. Yeah. I mean, she already knows that. But, it's, you know, it was because I want to be closer to home. But now, it's like, oh, I don't like this place. I don't like it anymore. Don't go, dummy. I don't like it anymore, so I'm not happy. And they know, teachers know that. I'm not happy. It's too much bullshit. Too much shit, man. Go, stupid. Letting you in. It's supposed to rain later, and I have my fog togs with me. A very big percentage of rain is coming. Sorry, dude. I should have stopped. There's somebody behind me. Yeah, it's gonna rain, so I got my frog togs with me and my backpack ready to go. Well, this person has to go to the right. Go ahead. Go, stupid. Go. Hold on, man. Man, he had to go. No wonder your fucking door is fucked up. Gosh. Tell you guys, it's worse on the street like this. You're more likely to get into an accident on these streets than you are on the freeway. Much scarier on the streets. Look at this guy. See, he could have just gone right in front of me. I'm going 40 some miles an hour. It just went. Same thing here. Gotta watch out. Oh, goodness gracious me. Day tripper, yeah. Yeah, yeah. Got a good reason. This is one of the first songs I learned on guitar. Day tripper. She was a day tripper. One Sunday driver, yeah. Took me so long to find out, but I found out. Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy. Tomorrow I have to go to court. Yeah, I have to go to court tomorrow. They said I ran a red light with that stupid camera shit. And, of course I didn't. And it shows in the video I stopped. They still took a picture of me. Thanks, man. So, yeah, now I gotta go over there. In front of the judge. Because who wants to pay a $600 ticket for something that they didn't do? So stupid. What are you doing, dummy? Let it be. Move, scooter. Have a great Wednesday, guys. Just let it be. Let it be. Just let it be. Ride safe out there, guys. We'll see ya.